So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. Main hu Manish Mishra and in today's session guys I will bring to you some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the economic and social issues topic of RBI Grade B and NABARD. And NABARD ki mains ki date kabhi bhi aa sakti hai, so boost up your preparations guys. Please do not wait for the official notification of the exam date. Jo jaisa bhi aapka exam hua hai, keep on preparing. So let's begin with the today's session, but before we begin, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will find the PDF of this session after its completion. And you can also follow me here. Here also you can ask any doubt. So doubt puchne ke liye there are various channels. So bas aap doubt puchne wale bano, we are here for you. Let's talk about the very first question, which is regarding the G20 Agriculture Ministers meeting. So this question guys I have taken because NABARD का जो मेन्स है उसके लिए काफी इंपॉर्टेंट हो जाता है. सो द क्वेश्चन इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग वॉज द टॉपिक और थीम ऑफ G20 एग्रीकल्चर मिनिस्टर्स मीटिंग. एग्रीकल्चर मिनिस्टर मीटिंग की G20 की एग्रीकल्चर मिनिस्टर मीटिंग हुई थी, उसका टॉपिक या फिर उसका थीम आपको बताना है. ऑलराइट, सो रिमेंबर गाइस द टॉपिक यू कैन से द थीम वॉज रिसर्च एज अ ड्राइविंग फोर्स बिहाइंड सस्टेनेबिलिटी. रिसर्च एज अ ड्राइविंग फोर्स बिहाइंड सस्टेनेबिलिटी वॉज द टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन अमंग ऑल द G20 agriculture minister, and these are some of the key points which were delivered by the union minister of agriculture and farmers welfare Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar. Unhone kuch baatein kahi hain, dekh lete hain kya hai. So first of all he said that India has an annual production of food grains of 308 million tons, and with that India is not only sufficient in its for its own needs, but also India is fulfilling the needs of other countries as well. Then he said that oil seeds technology mission has doubled the production of oil seeds in the last 10 years. Pichle 10 saalon mein jo oil seeds ki production hai, because of oil seed technology mission it has been doubled. Then by the year 2030-31 he said that India's population will be around 150 crores, and for that around 350 million tons of food grains will be required, and for that India is well prepared. Iske liye India kafi aaram se bahut acche se taiyar hai, and itna hum target aaram se achieve kar lenge. All right, then agriculture is contributing to the three biggest challenge of the 21st century. And what are the three biggest challenge of the 21st century? These are achieving food security, adapting to the climate change, and mitigating the climate change. So agriculture is solving all these three problems of the 21st century. Then he said that we have developed and released 17 varieties of different crops which are resistant to biotic and abiotic stresses. And also he said that ICAR is developing biofortified varieties to meet the nutritional requirement of the citizens of India. And of course basically puri duniya ke liye aisa ye kaam kar rahe hain. All right, so these are guys some of the key points which were delivered by the union minister of agriculture and farmers welfare. So here the question is regarding which of the following was the topic or theme. The correct answer is research as a driving force behind sustainability is the correct answer. And guys, last year in UPSC in the 2020 pre there was a question that which of the following is not a member of G20 countries. So G20 countries mein of course there are 19 countries and one European Union, so very it is quite difficult to remember the names of all the G20 countries. So you never know, this question will come in future in RBI or in NABARD also. तो उसको याद करने का एक छोटा सा तरीका मैंने इंटरनेट पे देखा था कुछ टाइम पहले, तो मेरे को उसी से याद हुआ है, आप भी उसी से कर लो. द ट्रिक इज गुरुजी सीता अब एसएससी एफसीआई, देयर इज अ रिक्रूटमेंट ऑफ एफसीआई इन एसएससी, विद द हेल्प ऑफ दैट यू कैन रिमेंबर दिस, में जॉब करती है. बस ऐसे याद रखना है सो दैट आपको सेंटेंस पता रहे कि क्या है. जो हमारा निमोनिक्स है वो इसी में से है, गुरुजी सीता अब एसएससी एफसीआई में जॉब करती है. एंड विच आर द 19 कंट्रीज एंड वन इज द यूरोपियन यूनियन, ओके, एंड 19 आर द कंट्रीज. सो दीज कंट्रीज आर जर्मनी, यूएसए, रशिया, यूके. एक बार लिख ले ये वाला सेंटेंस याद करके, एक बार खुद से बोल देना तो याद हो जाएगा, डोंट वरी. जर्मनी, यूएसए, रशिया, यूके, जापान, इंडिया, सऊदी अरेबिया, इंडोनेशिया, टर्की, अर्जेंटीना, ऑस्ट्रेलिया, ब्राजील, साउथ अफ्रीका, साउथ कोरिया, देन वी हैव कनाडा, फ्रांस, चाइना, इटली, मेक्सिको एंड यूरोपियन यूनियन. सो दीज आर द 20 कंट्रीज ऑफ G20. एंड G7 और G8 कंट्रीज याद रखना इज वेरी इजी, बट G20 ऑफ कोर्स आप 20 कंट्रीज की लिस्ट याद नहीं कर सकते, इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट, यू हैव टू यूज सम काइंड ऑफ निमोनिक्स. तो मैं यूज ये वाला यूज करता हूं, मैंने इंटरनेट पे देखा था कहीं पे, सो यू कैन ऑल्सो यूज दिस. नाउ मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर टू. विद विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग टू कंपनीज ट्राइफेड हैज साइंड एमओयू टू मेक अवेलेबल द वनधन प्रोडक्ट्स ऑन बिज. ओके क्वेश्चन में आंसर आ गया. ऑन द डैश प्लेटफॉर्म एंड टू प्रमोट The art of growing pearls among the tribal entrepreneurs respectively. तो एक कंपनी तो आपको दिखाई दे गई, क्वेश्चन में लिख दिया था मैंने बाय मिस्टेक, इट इज बिग बास्केट. एंड अनदर कंपनी गाइज इज द पूर्ति एग्रोटेक. अनदर कंपनी इज पूर्ति एग्रोटेक एंड नंबर वन कंपनी इज बिग बास्केट. सो द एमओयू ट्राइफेड हैज साइंड विद दीज टू कंपनीज, बिग बास्केट एंड पूर्ति एग्रोटेक. विद बिग बास्केट, जो बिग बास्केट के साथ एमओयू हुआ है उसके बारे में बात कर लेते हैं, पहले डिटेल में बात कर लेते हैं. लेट्स नॉट कट शॉर्ट द न्यूज, वन सेकेंड. यस, सो टॉकिंग अबाउट द एमओयूज विद दिस बिग बास्केट, सो अंडर दिस एमओयू ट्राइफेड विल यूज द एक्सपर्टीज एंड इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर ऑफ बिग बास्केट. बिग बास्केट का इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर और उनकी एक्सपर्टीज को यूज करेंगे फॉर वॉट, फॉर मेकिंग अवेलेबल द वन हैंड प्रोडक्ट्स ऑन द बिग बास्केट प्लेटफॉर्म. सो द कस्टमर्स कैन विजिट टू द बिग बास्केट .com एंड दे कैन अवेल द वन हैंड प्रोडक्ट्स. ऑलराइट. And talking about the MOU with Purti Agrotech. So guys, Purti Agrotech, remember it is a pearl making company. ये कंपनी क्या करती है? Pearl बनाती है. So under this MOU, what will happen? The art of growing pearls among the tribal entrepreneurs will be promoted. Pearls बनाने का जो art है, उसको promote किया जाएगा among the tribal entrepreneurs. And also, Trifed will create a good market for this unique craft. And at the same time, it will provide Purti Agrotech various facilities so that they can run their enterprise in more professional manner. Okay. So this was about this news, and hence guys the correct answer is what? Big Basket and Purti Agrotech 1 and 4. Option D 1 and 4 will be the correct answer. And talking more about Trifed, so it was established in the year 1987 under Multi-State Cooperative Society Act. Multi-State Cooperative Society Act of 1984. It is headquartered in New Delhi. Headquartered in New Delhi, and who is the CEO? Mr. Praveer Krishna. Praveer Krishna is the CEO. Praveer Krishna. And recently, Trifed has launched Sankalp Se Siddhi program. Sankalp Se Siddhi. Trifed has launched Sankalp Se Siddhi program, and recently also Trifed has partnered with Niti Aayog. Niti Aayog for what? For implementing Vandhan initiative in the aspirational districts of the country. In the tribal aspirational district, not aspirational, tribal aspirational district of the country. And also very recently Trifed has got the award for excellence in PSUs for investment in startups. Okay, so these are some recent news about Trifed, and now let's move ahead to question number 3. With which of the following universities National Commission for Women has launched a capacity building and personality development program for women undergraduate and postgraduate students. So this is basically a capacity building program launched by National Commission for Women. National Commission for Women, Rekha Sharma is the chairperson. She was recently reappointed. Ye pehle bhi thi, and now she was recently reappointed as the chairperson of National Commission for Women. It was established in the year 1992 under the National Commission for Women Act of 1990. And it is also headquartered in New Delhi. So let's talk about this capacity building program. So the National Commission for Women has launched this program, which is a capacity building program for women students from undergraduate and postgraduate. All right. And this program, remember, has been launched in collaboration with the Central University of Haryana. Central University of Haryana ke saath collaboration mein is program ko launch kiya hai. And the commission will also collaborate with other universities and other colleges for launching courses, for launching this program under three topics: personal capacity building, professional career skills, and digital literacy and use of social media. All right. Now the program or the course, you can say it has three categories hoga jo abhi humne padha: personal capacity building, professional skills, and then digital literacy and effective use of social media. And of course, after completion of all the three sessions, the woman who is taking the session can have a quiz from mygov.in. All right. And after completing that quiz, they will get a certificate for that. So guys, the correct answer is what? The correct answer to this question is Central University of Haryana. Option D will be the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 4, which is very important regarding the Global Innovation Index. Consider the following statements with respect to Global Innovation Index, and you have to identify the correct statement. So let's talk about it. So who releases the Global Innovation Index? It's World Intellectual Property Organization, which is headquartered in Geneva. And who is the chief? It's Darren Tang. Darren Tang is the chief of World Intellectual Property Organization. And this organization has launched this index, which is known as Global Innovation Index. And this index, guys, measures the innovation power of a country. And this time there were total 132 countries in the innovation power, innovation ability was measured under this particular index. And remember the India launch of Global Innovation Index and Global Innovation Conclave was organized by Niti Aayog in partnership with Confederation of Indian Industry, CII. And who is the chairperson of CII for the year 2021? It's Mr. T.V. Narendran is the chairperson, or you can say the president of CII for 2021. He is the MD and CEO of Tata Steel. And moving ahead to the results of this index. So globally, there are 81 indicators grouped into innovation input and innovation output. Two parts of indicators divided in total 81. Globally, number one pe it is Switzerland, number two is Sweden, then we have USA, UK, and Republic of Korea, or you can say the South Korea. Alright. Republic of Korea is for the very first time has secured this rank number 5. Talking about India, so India's performance, India has been ranked at 46 with a score of 36.4. And talking about the innovation input wale indicator ki agar hum baat kare to India has been ranked at 57, while in the output category India is at 45th rank. All right. And among the Asian countries, only 4 are in the top 15, which are Singapore, China, Japan and Hong Kong, with rank 8, 12, 13 and 14 respectively. All right. So isme isse zyada padhna mat, bahut lambi chaudi report hai, of course itna zyada padhne ki zarurat nahi hai, sirf itna hi padh lo, isi mein se paper mein aa jayega. Let's come back to the question then. Sweden has been ranked number 1. So is that Sweden? No, that's Switzerland. Switzerland is ranked number 1. There are 4 Asian countries in top 15. Yes, absolutely correct. India has been ranked at 44th with a score of 36.4. Yes, the score is 36.4, but rank is not 44. That's 46th. So this is also incorrect. Only 2 will be the correct answer, guys. Option A. Alright, I hope this question is clear. Now moving ahead to last question for today, question number 5. What is the estimated production of food grains as per the first advanced estimates of production of major kharif crops for the year 21-22? And this is very important for the upcoming NABARD mains. Isme question zarur aayega, ARD ka bhi part hai ya ESI ka bhi part hai, sabka part hai. So you can expect a question from this first advanced estimates. And isme you don't have to remember everything, because there are a lot of numbers that you of course can't remember. The question, in my opinion, this will be the question that will come in your exam. Agar aaya to yehi wala question hoga ki food grains ka kitna production hai, kitna advance estimate hai. So let's talk about the facts then. Let's talk about the numbers that has been released under the first advance estimates. So talking about the food grains, so that is 150.50 million tons. That is a record estimate production. Rice, 107.04 million tons. This is again a record. अब ये सारे याद मत करो, नो प्रॉब्लम. जो रिकॉर्ड वाले हैं वो याद कर लो, एंड जो हाईलाइटेड है वो याद रखना. ऑलराइट, द हाईलाइटेड वंस यू हैव टू रिमेंबर, एंड वेयर वी आर मेकिंग द रिकॉर्ड दैट इज आल्सो वर्थ रिमेंबरिंग. ऑयल सीड्स दैट 23.39 मिलियन टन्स. कॉटन 36.22 मिलियन बेल्स. ऑलराइट, दिस इज अगेन अ रिकॉर्ड. जूट एंड मेस्टा 9.61 मिलियन बेल्स. एंड फाइनली शुगर केन 419.25 मिलियन टन्स. This is again a record. So there are 4 record making data here regarding sugarcane, cotton, and then we have regarding food grains, rice. Yes, so these are the 4 where we are making the records. So now let's come back to the question. There, the question is regarding the food grains. So that's 150.50 million tons. Option B, guys, will be the correct answer to this question. All right. So I hope, guys, all the questions are clear, and if you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Milte hain Monday ke session mein. I'll see you on Monday. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.